Imagine that you're a dinosaur. You have the teeth, the scales, the unimaginable power, and a serious roar. And you're quietly going about another day, around 66 million years ago. Life is probably pretty good. You're a giant roaming the landscape of a lush green planet. But the world is about to change. In the skies, there is a light, an object that hasn't always been there. And while Earth had certainly been struck by asteroids in the past, before now, this something from space is the first of its type for many millions of years. Of course, we know what happens next. The rock hits, the conditions on Earth are cast into untold chaos, and the dinosaurs disappear. It's a truly crucial before and after moment, a point in time after which the story of life took an all new direction. But what would have happened if it had never happened at all? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if the asteroid never killed the dinosaurs?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
There are surely few more momentous moments in the history of the Earth than when a 6.2-mile or 10-kilometer-wide asteroid struck our planet around 66 million years ago. Hurtling into the Yucatan Peninsula of modern-day Mexico, the cataclysmic impact caused an explosion several billion times as powerful than the Hiroshima atomic bomb to trigger mega tsunamis, massive volcanic eruptions, and worldwide wildfires. A thick blanket of ash, debris, and soot suffocated all types of until then livable environments, blocking out the sun, sending everything into darkness, and causing temperatures to rise and fall to unparalleled extremes. It was doomsday for the dinosaurs. Having reigned on Earth for more than 180 million years, the dinosaurs were wiped out by one colossal chunk of space rock that just so happened to cross their planet's path. But while traditional theories often imply that the death and destruction were almost instantaneous, contemporary science has cast more than a few questions over exactly how, when, and why the dinos died. Some scientists suggest that dinosaurs were already in decline even before the asteroid event. Their evolutionary heyday is usually considered as the late Triassic period, around 220 million years ago, when new species were appearing and evolving far quicker than others were dying out. However, around 120 million years later, so around 40 million years before the asteroid impact, dino populations were falling fairly fast, particularly among the meat-eating theropods, including the tyrannosaurs. The downturn wasn't a blanket rule for all species, but the dinosaurs' dwindling fortunes may have contributed to their eventual inability to survive their own apocalypse. On the other side, some theories argue that the dinosaurs would have easily and inevitably regained their upward curve had the asteroid never happened, or if it had hit the oceans rather than land. Sure, some species' figures had been in decline, but the trend wasn't entrenched, and extinction would have still seemed almost impossible. In fact, some scientists say that some species of dinosaur may still have walked the Earth between 30,000 and 300,000 years even after the asteroid hit. So that fateful rock may not have been the absolute final straw, but it almost certainly marked the beginning of the end. But what if it never happened at all? What if the asteroid had just missed Earth, the ancient ecosystems had continued to flourish, and the dinosaurs had never even encountered their atmospheric Armageddon, because it was never inflicted upon them? What might the world be like now? In the days, weeks, and months after the asteroid, it was definitely survival of the smallest. The largest dinosaurs were worst affected, mostly because the disaster decimated the food chain, leaving the bigger beasts with nowhere near enough to eat. Edible creatures were understandably hard to come by, and plant stocks were severely depleted given the dramatic changes in temperature, weather, and soil. All of this was essentially good news for us humans, though. Of course, we weren't there at the time, but it meant that a very small number of early mammals, which were tiny, shrew-like creatures back then, could survive while the predators perished. In a world without the asteroid, this shift isn't likely to have happened, so there's no real reason to believe that the rise of the mammals would have ever occurred, so you and everyone else would have never existed. The asteroid directly or indirectly killed off around three-quarters of the planet's species at the time, and while there is evidence that some dino breeds may have eventually disappeared through natural selection, it's probable that the majority would have continued to develop in a world without the rock. It's true that many of today's birds are actually distant descendants of various avian creatures from many millions of years ago, But the land-dwelling lizards were also far more intelligent and adaptable than modern stereotypes imply. And that's partly because some of them were less lizard-like than we often imagine. There's evidence that some dinosaurs were at least partly warm-blooded, so particular species could have easily applied themselves to any ice age thrown their way, and continue to thrive across all regions and environments on Earth. Major fossil finds are typically uncovered in dry and dusty desert landscapes, but that's mostly because these are areas where bones are best preserved and most easily accessible, and not because they're the only locations where dinosaurs lived. The 2015 discovery of Ugunalak kukpakenis in Arctic Alaska kick-started a now ever-growing appreciation of just how far dinosaur populations had spread. So had they not been halted by the asteroid, their all-conquering versatility would have likely increased. Today, the word dinosaur has come to mean anything that's clumsy or outdated. But that description was probably far from true for the seemingly unstoppable creatures themselves. It's almost impossible to guess how the dinosaurs would have evolved over the 66 million years between when the Cretaceous period was suddenly ended and now. But most theorists agree that there would have been significant changes. World-famous forms such as the Tyrannosaurus rex and Triceratops would no doubt have dramatically altered to suit their developing environments. For a measure of what can be achieved within the time frame, just consider the mammals' progress from small, shrew-like life forms into today's dominant and diverse creatures. The improvements are obviously vast. And given that the dinosaurs seem to deal solely in superlatives, the fastest, strongest, tallest, and longest species are likely to have become even more incredible in size and shape. The development of dinosaur intelligence would have been key, and has been subject for continuous speculation, with the Troodon usually taking center stage. Troodon boasted a comparatively large brain for its relatively small size, and is thought to have been one of the smartest dinosaurs at the point of extinction. It walked on its hind legs and had large forward-facing eyes, leading many to muse that the cleverest dinosaurs were headed for a more human-like body shape. The so-called dinosauroid might have become fully bipedal while retaining scaly skin, sharper teeth, and clearer vision to look something like the stereotypical Area 51 alien. However, many paleontologists argue that this vision is only the product of human arrogance, as there's little reason to believe that future dinosaurs would have looked anything like us, barring an enormous evolutionary coincidence. The human design is good, but alternate options are endless, and our forms aren't an undisputed end goal for all living things. That said, had the dinosaurs been allowed to evolve and improve for millions of years more, the emergence of mammals would have been increasingly difficult, if not impossible. Dinosaurs so conclusively dominated the food chain that even had their numbers fell, the opportunities for a species overhaul would have been basically non-existent. Dino intelligence may have never expanded into anything to match our own. Crocodiles have been on Earth longer than us, and they're not running for president yet. But that wouldn't matter so long as they topped the natural order, and who or what was ever going to challenge them? If the asteroid had never killed the dinosaurs, the chances are then that untold future versions of Velociraptor and company, with or without human standard brains, would still be roaming the wilds of Earth today. Unless the planet presented an alternative means of extinction, namely global warming. It may feel like a modern phenomenon, but global warming and climate change did and hypothetically would have caused major problems for the dinosaurs too. The Mesozoic era, formed of the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods, played host to large-scale changes on Earth, not least the breakup of Pangaea into separate landmasses that eventually became the seven continents of today. As a general rule, the planet was thriving until the asteroid hit, in some parts like a show garden in full bloom. Flowers were emerging and plants were diversifying, but atmospheric changes, including shifts in carbon dioxide and oxygen levels, were too much for some species. Coupled with widespread and unprecedented volcanic eruptions both before and after the asteroid impact, the world might have been well on its way to wiping out the dinosaurs anyway. The space rock just cleared the slate quicker. In time, this might have set the scene for an alternative rise of the mammals, just at a later point in history. Or it might have ushered in an altogether different dominant species. Obviously, we'll never know for sure. But we're alive to even consider the possibilities at this exact point in time, thanks in large part to that famously wayward, world-ruining rock. 21st century dinosaurs never became a reality, but even if they had, then we more than likely wouldn't be here to appreciate them. The day the asteroid hit was a death knell for the dinosaurs, but a new beginning for us, sparking 66 million years worth of awesome evolution, all so that you can watch this video today. As always, let us know what you think. Hit the comments with anything dinosaur-related. All interesting facts, thoughts, and theories are welcome. How do you think history might have played out differently if they were never killed off? What do you imagine the world would be like now if T-Rex was still the top dog? Or is it your view that humans would still have emerged, one way or another? And finally, if you have a video title that you really want to see made, then be sure to let us know about that as well.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.